Well, I plan to fight my new style. I want to announce here now the new style about landing a rope sometime, letting a man punch himself out. It is called the rope-a-dope.
The rope-a-dope.
Rope-a-dope.
Who does the word dope honor?
It honors whoever chases me in the rope.
All right.
He's fighting this fight. Stop fighting this fight and land on the ropes.
Okay.
Come on, stay in the middle. You're fighting in the beautiful in the middle of the ring. Don't stay on the ropes. Don't fight his fight.
Filipino is moving. First time Pacquiao had his back against the ropes. Freddie Roach doesn't want to see it. Manny landed a little right hook in there. And follows up by knocking Cotto down. First knockdown of the fight. Two rounds to one, Pacquiao. Cotto hopping Pacquiao against the ropes. So far, round four has belonged to Miguel Cotto. And that was either hand. But since the knockdown, it seems Cotto has tightened his defense a bit. He's not getting hit as much since the knockdown took place. Pacquiao against the ropes. Freddie Roach thinks this is a very bad idea. Cotto pounding away. He's got the big advantage when Pacquiao's against the ropes.
Cotto is beating down bigger fighters.
I think he's taking a breather, but I don't think he's hurt. You know, he had a good flare right there. He's resting up. At this point, he's catching every punch that Cotto throws.
Well, the reason he's taking a breather, Manuel, may be that he's taking more punches than we've seen him take.
Well, you know, he's got a guy that not just saying that Cotto can beat him physically, handling, but that's Cotto's style anyway, is to be a bully. Some guys are bigger, but they're not known for being physical.
He may have gone to the ropes to let Cotto throw, thinking he could counter him with something big. Now
so.
It's Cotto whose back is against the ropes, and he fights his way off and goes down again. Cotto landed a big left-hand shot, and then Pacquiao caught him with the right hook again.
And Cotto was hurt by that knockdown, where he wasn't hurt by the first one.
He pushes Pacquiao to the ropes. Pacquiao puts up the guard. Head up again. Pacquiao was stunned by a left hook there as he came off the ropes.
The right jab from angle to score that. There he goes again. Weird punches from weird angles. He can sense the right punch to throw at the right time.
I think he senses that Cotto is weakening, and he's trying to see if he can finish how he's handling it, and then some.
And Cotto is beginning to retreat constantly, and he almost went down again. On a solid left-hand shot by Pacquiao. And Cotto tries to finish the round and lands a thudding right hand right on Pacquiao's chin, and Manny grins as he walks away. Cotto was engaged in, but now Pacquiao's backing him off again. Got him against the ropes. Tries to end it with one big left hand, but missed.
And he's
with the left uppercut. Cotto backs into the corner. He's in big trouble now. The fight could end in a matter of seconds.
This is a human typhoon.
Kenny Bayless is within his rights in stopping this.
To do it, to dramatize it with a knockout.
And now the crowd is booing Cotto's retreat. A difficult moment for such a proud warrior.
Pacquiao stares at him dismissively. We're running.
Wanted to stop the fight and was talked out of it by the others in the corner, including head trainer Joe Santiago. Now Kenny Bayless does his duty.
We thought Manny Pacquiao was great. He's better than we thought.
The 50th win of Pacquiao's now legendary career.
I would have to call him an all-time great. I mean, I am very impressed. And not just so much for just this performance, but he's been since 2001 fighting the best fighters all the way from featherweight all the way up now to welterweight, Mr. Scott, and been performing on a top level in every fight. I've never known a fighter to do that.